When you work with satellite project, people always assume that you want to go to Mars. But actually, if you know about space, you usually don't want to put people in space. People break very easily and they need oxygen and food and everything.
And gravity.
Just put computers in space. That's enough for me. So as a teenager, I was always kind of maker type, but I still hadn't realized that I actually would like to study technology. Then it hit me after high school that this hobby could actually be a profession to me. It seemed that the things that they are doing now at the university were the things that I was doing as a hobby.
I discovered programming when I was about 14. As I improved myself with that skill, I thought at some point I have to start making something real, like building electronics. At first I was just messing around with electricity.
Did you get any nice electric shocks?
I soldered my hand on something. Aalto 3 is the youngest child of the Aalto satellite family.
The Aalto 3 has two payloads, both developed by students here in Aalto University. The first is software-defined radio.
The secondary payload is a Bluetooth bus for the internal communication of the satellite.
The mission is to demonstrate that the Bluetooth can be used to communicate between different parts of the satellite. Great thing about projects such as Aalto 3 is that you can do so much. For example, you can design the satellite, but you can also work with social media or manage the team and organize events.
To get involved in the project, you don't have to specialize in space technology.
You just need to have the passion for space technology, and then you're welcome to work with the project.
It was pretty easy to make friends here, since there are so much people with similar interests.
Yeah, I agree. You could tell about your hobbies and building stuff and everyone was interested, unlike in high school. So when I was in high school, building stuff was kind of weird, and when I told people about my...
I'm sorry!
It's still weird! Then when I was trying to tell people about my projects in high school, people looked at me a little weirdly because apparently it wasn't normal to have a robot hand turning your stereo on. But when I came here, it was like a whole new world when everyone was making projects and everyone was excited about, for example, guiding your dog with Bluetooth.
Someone actually cared about the technical details.
The advice I would give to people like I was when I was younger is that don't wait until you have to do something. You can start working with technology project and so on already, even without school's help, at least if you have internet.
My advice to high school students is that don't wait for the others and don't set limits to yourself.